Hello, my name is Bisi Oladipopo and welcome to my podcast. My website can be found at www.inspiredwords.org. Today, I'll be sharing on the importance of growing in grace. So what is grace? This is one definition of grace. Grace is God's ability and empowerment. As we go through some scriptures, we will see this definition confirmed. Now, Ephesians 4:7, and I read, "But unto every one of us is given grace, according to the gift of the measure of Christ." This is good news, as we can see the measure of grace available to us all. 2 Peter 3:18 says that we should grow in grace. And I'll actually read 2 Peter 3:18, and I read, "But grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ." So here we are told to grow in grace. We all have capacity for more grace. So what do we need grace for? Here are a few things, amongst others, that we need grace for. We need grace to minister our giftings one to another, 1 Peter 4:10. We need grace to serve God acceptably, Hebrews 12:28. We need grace to labor in his vineyard, Ephesians 3:7, 1 Corinthians 15:10, and 1 Corinthians 3:10. To confirm the definition of grace, I will read one of these scriptures, 1 Corinthians 15:10, and I read, "But by the grace of God I am what I am. And his grace, which was bestowed upon me, was not in vain, but I labored more abundantly than they all, yet not I, but the grace of God, which was with me." So we can see here that the grace of God enabled Paul to labor more than they all. And he clearly defines why he could labor more than them all, yet not I, but the grace of God, which was with me. We can see here very clearly that grace is God's empowerment. Now, we also need grace in time of need, Hebrews 4:16. Grace helps us so sin does not have dominion over us, Romans 6 verse 14. We minister by grace, Romans 12 3. We need grace to minister powerfully, Acts 4:33, and I read, "And with great power gave the apostle witness of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all." So we can see a connection between great power and great grace. If you notice, most letters in the New Testament start out by speaking about grace and peace, and in some cases, mercy. Why the emphasis is on grace today? Is there a reason why many letters start and end with "grace be unto you"? Let's read just a few of these verses. Philippians 1:2, and I read, "Grace be unto you, and peace from God our Father, and from the Lord Jesus Christ." Titus 1:4, "To Titus, my own son, after the common faith, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ." Just a slight detour. We can see that grace comes from God alone. Hebrews 4:15 also mentions that we should come boldly unto the throne of grace. This is one reason, amongst others, that we need to abide within our call, because grace comes from God alone. Paul was called by the Lord, and the grace necessary was given to him from the Lord. If we force ourselves into what we are not called to, there will be no grace, because grace comes from the Lord and not man. Now let's look at some verses where the author ends with grace. The last verse of the Bible, Revelation 22 verse 21, "The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all." The last verse in the book of Philippians, Philippians 4:23, "The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all." There are so many verses that start and finish with grace in the scriptures, but I will leave it here for now. So how do we grow in grace? By being humble. James 4:6 and 1 Peter 5:5 speaks about God giving grace to the humble. Through the knowledge of God and Jesus Christ our Lord. 2 Peter 1:2, and I read, "Grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord." We can also ask for grace. This is what Hebrews 4:15 tells us to do in time of need. Asking for grace is a sign of humility. So we can see that grace is essential in our walk with the Lord. We are not left to struggle on our own. Pursuing the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ causes grace and peace to be multiplied unto us. We should also remember that pride is an enemy of more grace. James 4:6, and I read, "But he giveth more grace, wherefore he said, God resists the proud, but gives grace unto the humble." More means the humble gets more grace. We need grace in our Christian life. Grace is God's empowerment to do what he has called us to do, to help us to minister to others, to help us serve God acceptably with reverence and godly fear. It gives us dominion over sin. Grace helps us in time of need. Remember when the Lord told Paul, and he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. 2 Corinthians 12:9. In conclusion, we can see that grace has already been given to us according to the gift of the measure of Christ. We just need to apply ourselves and take advantage of principles in the kingdom of God that will cause us to grow in grace and will cause grace to be multiplied unto us. 2 Peter 2:1 reads, thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. The good news is, it's a gospel of grace, and grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. So next time, if you happen to share the grace at the end of the meeting, we all know it. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, let this mean more to you. Thanks for listening.